opened 15 bottles of cider and dumped them all over the warehouse floor when I leased that. It's a ship.
Why is it that you say things like that and I want to throw a chair at you?
Because you love it.
How does this work?
I'm just hustling my way into it now.
Clearly,
because you were like,
I
just want to make the cider. And I'm like, well.
I do.
Like, how does this exactly work, right? Because we're collaborating.
Well, it's going to all work at the same time.
That's what I'm saying.
Like a
we're gonna collaborate.
Beautiful symphony.
We're going to collaborate.
On this episode, I attempt to make wild forge cider.
I'm up at knife point right now. Can I get, I'm going to take the film.
As long as my collaborator and I don't kill each other first.
I will stab you. Whoa.
Join me as I attempt to hunt, forage, and farm my way across the globe in search of the world's best ingredients. I'm Kelly Cox, and this is The Original Fair. Years ago, the show brought me to Eugene, Oregon. Remember the truffle episode? What I found was a community of groundbreakers, artisans, and a cider that got me interested in ciders. Ran by this guy, Sean. We kept in touch, and after inheriting a garden full of plums in Portland, I brought them down to him.
I've got...
Oh, you got plums that are probably juicing themselves at this point.
You know better than me. I got boxes.
You want to just take them out of this house for the girl?
Yeah.
Let's go down there. Yeah. Let's
do it. But, like, I haven't seen your face in... Oh, 2 years. I know. Are you still coming to Portland?
I don't make it that much.
Wait, you're going to come on the 24th, right?
I'm coming on the 24th. Yeah, I've got some major projects happening. You guys are Brooks plumber, right?
I don't know. I just inherited a garden that gave me 200 pounds of plums. Mm. Mm. For those of us at home who maybe want to make something, like that was the biggest hurdle. It's like, I understand somewhat fermentation, but everybody's like, you buy the yeast, you buy the culture. And I'm like, that's not how Sean does it. I know he does it in a different way, and that's what I want to do.
Yeah.
I wouldn't want to add anything to this because it's all there.
It's there, it's present.
Biologically, mm-hmm. But then how do you extract that and like amplify it?
It's just
it's
so
the
incredible.
Same way, though.
And it frustrates the hell out of me that we.
And as all great ideas work, a couple of beers in, we decide to make cider together.
My
brother has
and it gets you nowhere.
My brother has a guide.
It gets you nothing.
My brother has a guide.
Because you have the right gear.
I'm Brendan. Do you know that?
Kelly. You gotta get better gear.
No. We should not be calling out other ciders.
I'm not gonna call out who
there
they
There needs
are.
To be I'm some sort of industry respect.
I'm just trying to understand what I'm tasting in ciders that I don't like. So where do you think these apples are coming from?
Oh. Washington.
Ugh. Ugh.
Yeah.
Ugh. No. Why is it so sweet? I feel awful.
Yeah.
Like suddenly I just feel awful.
There's two reasons for that. One, the mixture of alcohol and sugar together. Two, potassium metabisulfite. So sweet products need to be
potassium
pasteurized.
Metabisulfite.
They want it to be shelf stable, and they also just think the consumer can't handle that.
Are you ready for pumpkin?
So we're trying a pumpkin cider, which means that you can make cider out of anything.
There's no regulation on what they can say on the label.
We believe in creating nothing from one location.
No, we don't.
It's grow the olives in California, press them here. Mm-hmm. Grow grapes in Missouri, mm-hmm. bring them here.
Move everything all over the place, all the time.
Moving it around all the time.
And then just tearing out our orchards. It's fun.
Perry is what?
Perry is made from pears. Like cider is made from apples. This is cider back sweetened with pear juice.
There's no nuance to it.
I taste pear juice. Yeah. I don't really get character.
There is no character.
Mm-mm.
That's the real problem with the world.
No.
Very few have character.
Well, Kelly, we know you're not lacking in that.
That's the issue! Solved it!
Should have grabbed Farmhouse 7, because we're sitting under the Farmhouse 7 trees.
And so we head out to forage for elderberries.
If you look closely, you'll see a lot of food out there.
They on you, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then we can just hook and hook, and there we go. Get up. There's a decent little set. Let's grab these.
Those look good.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Do it.
Let's do this.
So why, besides the fact that I like the cider, why elderberries?
Why elderberries?
Yeah, when was the first, like, what got you onto them?
Oh, this is a really abundant, prolific Northwest ingredient. Ready right about the same time as pears, high medicinal properties, and it grows wild everywhere. It's, well,
are you cutting this, it with pears and
in
apples?
This case, it is the pear, yeah. In a blended pear, I've noticed with some fruits, you're actually getting more of the fruit aromatic when it's slightly diluted or blended with the proper pump fruit.
Is there any fruit you buy from people or buy, like, from a store?
No.
Is there a supermarket cider that you have?
No. Zero. Head down, and then make our way back up.
This way.
Okay. Sound good?
Mm-hmm.
What do you think of the elderberry juice?
I think why I like it is it reminds me of kind of like a Lambrusco.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit earthy, slightly sweet, effervescent.
Definitely has an earthy component to it,
I mean, I can get earthier, but we'll remember where we left our stuff.
Sweet, our first 25 pounds.
Okay, now.
How do you feel about it?
Oh. I got it.
All right. That's okay.
Hey.
Grabbing this box. You can't get everything that you want. That was what I was concerned about.
God damn it, John.
It's okay. Snapping branches. Blowing it.
This is what you do.
Blowing it, yeah. I come in and just destroy. Oh, come on. This is what I told you, I'm worried about your editing.
There's the pole.
Are we switching jobs now?
We just said we're going to both go separate ways.
I think we're going our separate ways, Kelly. No, it wasn't hard work, but we only worked for a couple hours.
You made it look pretty hard. There's a lot of huffing and puffing.
Oh.
Those are the sounds you make when you have to climb trees like a bear.
the Irish anger.
It's the Kelly's Irish anger. So I just want to start us out by pointing out how annoyed I am at you in this scene. Because this is the thing. I skipped a delicious crab buffet my last night in Sri Lanka so I could get 1 hour of sleep
to get up and film something with you at 2 a.m. my time, and you still weren't ready.
Fruit doesn't wait for Sri Lanka.
You're pressing the elderberries that have been sitting for, what, a month now?
3 weeks. They can deteriorate pretty quick. You know, they maybe have a week in cold storage before I feel like they're ready to go.
We've got these pears, which I miss the harvest of.
Oh, what you're seeing right here is one of the three different pear varieties we're introducing into the Elderberry Perry this year. It's like we're making the spices to spice a dish.
So the pears are the spice for our Elderberry Perry.
Essentially.
And then you've got some hay. We're using hay?
We're using straw. There's a difference between straw and hay. From Missouri, you should know this. It's strong, it's fibrous, it holds up under the pressure of the press, it doesn't impart flavor.
I think ultimately what I've been obsessed with since meeting you, I feel like it's been 50 years, but it's been two, 50 years ago, is the process. It sounds to me like what I was really wanting to wrap my brain around was just the fruit sitting there and letting it do its thing.
It's all about sourcing. Wild fermentation is very linked to its terroir, to its flowers, to its terrain, the lack of spray, the lack of water, the presence of water, the presence of other bacteria. Those are all coming into play. Are the ways that we live with our new changing habitat by fighting against the current? Or do we try to create means of coexisting and cohabitating to balance our old traditions with our new landscape?
This is us doing our final tasting, and you're going to annoy me to death.
We have to sit for it.
Clock your chair this way. Yeah, we have to sit. I mean, I don't know what you want to do. Would you rather be at a table? That's your T-Rex? It is a week. You need to be like...
It's the big chicken. It's the big chicken. You gotta move them out, but I don't know if there's not enough arm.
Give it a whiff.
Berry.
It's the final Earth. Countdown.
Moss. Dirt. Peel. Wild pear.
It's getting all professional on me.
Flavors of grape.
I just smell like
raspberry.
My sweat, blood, and tears.
Oh. Lord, help me.
All the hard work I put into this thing. Hey, I made it from Oregon to Ireland.
To an orchard in Ireland. So this is a blend of wild harvested seedling pears, orchards in Oregon.
What should we make in Ireland?
Gorse wine.
Gorse wine. Ladies first. Oh, how the hell did we get to Ireland? I thought we were done with it.
I don't know if I can spend another month here with you, so. Oh, la, 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 la.
Oh, here we go to Ireland. Why do you have to make my work so difficult sometimes?
Well, you know, I'm not an actor.
I'm not either. You have it's uncomfortable for me.
I get very uncomfortable on film.
I
figured that out.
Oh my god.
That way, keep going that way.
On the next episode of The Original Fair.
We worked too goddamn hard. Picking all your flowers and
a bunch of Irish folk search for our roots. Dairy farming. Muscle harvesting, meeting the grand dame of slow food, and a slew of local characters.
Whiskey goes in, secrets come out.
Ah!
Okay. Have a good time, folks.
Along with my most special guest ever, my mom. For more adventures in food, subscribe to our channel.